everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example about converting polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates. The polar coordinates that we're going to be given in this problem are 3, 3 pi over 2. And as with any problem where we're converting polar coordinates to Cartesian coordinates, we're going to be using these two formulas here, x equals r cosine of theta and y equals r sine of theta. And what we're going to do is we're going to plug in the two coordinates from our polar point in for r and theta. So in a polar point, the first coordinate here, 3, represents r, and 3 pi over 2 represents theta. So instead of the coordinates being x, y, they are r, theta. So we're going to plug in 3 for r and 3 pi over 2 for theta into both our x equation here and our y equation here. And when we simplify those, when we evaluate and simplify, that's going to give us our xy coordinate when we started out with our r theta coordinate. So let's go ahead and plug those in. And we get the following two equations. 3 cosine of 3 pi over theta, when we plugged in 3 for r and 3 pi over 2 for theta. And y equals 3 sine of 3 pi over 2. So now we're going to evaluate these and then simplify. So in order to evaluate, we need our unit circle. And we're going to be evaluating both of these at the angle 3 pi over 2. So what we do is we go over here to our unit circle, and we start at 0, and we work our way clockwise until we find, counterclockwise in the positive direction, until we find the angle 3 pi over 2, which is right down here. 3 pi over 2. So that's the angle at which we're going to be evaluating for cosine and sine. And then remember that when you're using the unit circle, cosine of the angle will give you the x coordinate here, in this case 0, and sine of the angle will give you the y coordinate, in this case negative 1. So we're going to end up plugging in 0 for cosine of pi over 3 in our x equation, and negative 1 for sine of 3 pi over 2 in our y equation. So when we do that, we're going to get 3 times 0, right, because we plugged in 0 for cosine of 3 pi over 2. And then when we simplify, of course, 3 times 0 is 0. And we do the same thing for y, and we get negative 1 for sine of 3 pi over 2. And when we simplify that, we, of course, get negative 3. So that's how we evaluate at the angle 3 pi over 2. And then we simplify. And now all we have to do to get the Cartesian coordinate is simply put these two together. So our Cartesian coordinate will end up being 0, negative 3. So that's how you convert a polar point, 3, 3 pi over 2, to a Cartesian point, in this case, 0, negative 3. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye!